Hey, what's up, guys? So, I'm Sarah, and I'm back. A bitch is back with my second makeup look. So, I'm gonna put the e.l.f. Camo Concealer on my eyelids because it actually, like, showed the colors really well. Like, the base, I guess. It really helped the colors come through. So, looks like this. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with like a brownish color. Like, I'll just show y'all. How about that? So, I'm gonna start off with either this one or that one, or maybe both, okay? Interrupted by a call. Anyways, so you know what I've seen over the years is that honestly, yeah, girls, you don't have to rush into makeup if you don't want to and if you're not ready. What I have seen though and experienced is people will literally judge you if like okay, let me say this. In a relationship, I've heard plenty of times, oh, Sarah, you're so sweet. Oh, you really changed my perspective. Oh, you know, you're a different kind of person. Oh, stuff like that. Like, but it's like, I've experienced moments of like people making me feel down about myself because, you know, like I wasn't into makeup like that yet and stuff like that. And it's kind of just like, so yeah, people, you know, act different because you're not into makeup like that too much, and you know, they're having these high expectations and looking at like people on the internet, and or if like say there's someone else around you that or walking past y'all that's like into, it's like, what I'm trying to say is I would literally like go out of my way to pull my boo aside and be like, yo, do this, I think you'll feel really good about this, or I'm into this, how about you try this, like I want to help somebody grow with me. But like, people aren't like that in the world. They'll literally make you feel as low as they can because first of all, there's something they're not sure with within themselves, and then they will lay it onto you. Everyone's journey is different, even two people together's journey is different, but like, people will be like mean and careless, and obviously take your time, but I will say, don't be scared. Like, you can even go into Sephora or any of these makeup stores and get samples of stuff if you don't want to like invest in something because you're not sure, you're scared. Walk in there, be, you know, to take charge of giving yourself that oomph to feel and good about yourself and grow, and go get samples, go home, try them and see how you feel. But don't let nobody rush you. But I'm just saying, like, a lot of pressures come with the quality of how one carries themselves. To be honest, a person who is going to make their partner feel a way or disrespect them because of what they are not currently using at a time, they don't deserve you, period. Like, scraps, trash. But y'all get the gist of what I'm saying. Take care of yourselves and try to upgrade for yourself, you feel me? Because I've experienced some shit that made me treat it. I just feel like people will tell you you're so special, but then still try to break you down so much. And, like, I am just not, like, I'm a strong-ass person. I'm a spiritual-ass person. Nobody could break me, okay? I'm so... Listen. Fuck people, okay? Do you. Do the best for you. Work hard. Take care of yourselves. Yourselves. You come first. Honestly, I feel like in your 20s, bitch, be greedy. In your 20s, worry about yourself. Period. Like... People out here will waste your time. People out here will waste your time. And even though everybody has their own ish about themselves, they'll still look at you and judge you and try to make you feel less than. It's like, bitch, are you all together? I think not. I digress. Like, people will really try you. Alright. Ooh, my phone light is blinding. Nobody wanna see us together, but it don't matter, no, 'cause I got you. Nobody wanna see us together, but it don't matter, no, 'cause I we gon' fight. Yes, we gon' fight. I think we gon' fight. Fight for our right to love. Nobody wants to see us together, but it don't matter, no. Okay, so I'm putting the brown, okay, darker brown. Now I'm gonna put some of the lighter brown in the middle-ish, below it. Yo, I know this look is gonna be sexy. Everything I do looks good. I'm just creative like that. Everything I do looks good. Okay, so you're just gonna blend the light brown in the middle, well, right below the brown, because I'm gonna put something totally different down on my eyelid. But y'all catch my drift. It's been so long since we had someone to look up to. But that's just nothing. So yeah, don't, honestly, do not rush for relationships, because people literally will try to tear you down. Like, bitch, we don't have time for that. Especially for in 2020. I really want to make a video about what we're not going to accept in 2020, because, bitch, people really got people fucked up. And it's time, like, it just needs to stop. Especially sensitive, dope-ass people like myself. Like, I will fucking try to heal, nurture, love, caress, build somebody, and what you doing? Shit, someone told me, oh, why are you so confident? Like, lower your confidence. Bitch. Get your life. Who you are is what you have. Your confidence is what you have. Don't let nobody take that from you. A stank butt person. At the end of the day, human is human. Keep that in mind. Okay. I'm liking this. liking this so far. I want to start singing, but I'm scared to sing out loud. I'm scared to sing and record it. I need to like break through my...
Baby, I just don't get it. Do you enjoy me? I know you smell the perfume.
Yo, when I put out my have like, you know, good feet every season, my brother told me he's proud of me. Grant, I love you. I love you, brother. My brother is my everything. My little sister. Oh my god. My little sister was like, I have to go sing a song, so I'm gonna sing Mario Let Me Love You. I was like, bitch. Hello? My brother and my sister are my heart, okay? Period. Okay, so I'm going to put maybe okay. I'm gonna put some of this one. So yo, I went into this store recently and I saw this brand, right? And it just reminded me of when, okay, basically we have a family reunion in Owen Sound, okay? And I have a cousin named Angelica. Hey boo, hey boo. And she had this, I was so young, y'all, but she had this, like, I don't know if it was a little crush or ex or boyfriend, I don't know, but, or just a friend, or I don't even remember, but I remember, I just thought he was so cute with his freckles, looking like a little doll in his blue eyes, blue or green eyes, and he had this Billabong sweater, and I held that sweater so fucking tight. Yeah, it just took me way back. It was so long ago, it took me way back. Yo, my cousin's a trip. I miss her. Like, there was a time where my mom left me up there to chill with her, and you know, me only had a little bit of money and whatnot, so whatever. And she was like, oh, we're gonna use your money for the cab to go back down to the park, which is where the reunion is held and whatnot. And so I was like, what the fuck, like, okay. And we went to see this guy who was supposedly, I don't know if he was in the, was he a cousin, or I don't know if he was a distant cousin or whatever, but he had one of the sweet, I don't know if he was from Detroit or where, but he had one of finest damn accents that I've ever heard in my life. Finest accents I've ever heard in my life. And yeah, I was like so in my feelings. I'm like, oh my god, like, first of all, it was awkward. I didn't really know why, like, whatever. So she was just chilling with him and holding hands and making out, and I was like, I don't know, I was just mad young. And I was like, oh, I'm left out. And so I grabbed, I don't know if it was his durag or his sweater or something. And I was just like, I don't know, I was crushing on him hard. And I was kind of low-key cheese, though. Because she made me use my little bit of money on the cab to go see that boy. His accent was amazing, though. Can't even lie. So I was just like, damn, yo, you're finna use my cab money? I'm gonna use my money for the cab to go meet this boy. Like, I miss my cousin though. I love you, Angie. Yo, so lately I've been meditating, right? And it is truly amazing. Now, I don't know if it's just because, like, I'm, you know, y'all, like I say in my videos, you know, I get all that spirit activity, I'm connected to another realm, blah, 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 blah. I'm connected to the angels, whatever. I don't know if it's that or whatever, but when I was meditating this the other day, because, you know, every family has issues and whatnot, and I just saw some clarification. And I don't really go to family gatherings or functions like that because I'm just better doing my own thing and being comfortable as a person doing my own thing. But I love my family, don't get it wrong, but I just am better off doing my own thing. I saw, like, things flashing through my head while I was meditating that was clear. I heard like an inner woman voice was showing me stuff and telling me what's okay and that I've overcome certain things, and it was just clarifying, and it was amazing. It was truly amazing. And then I was meditating again last night, and it's really weird. Like, I saw a female's face twice that I've never seen before, and it was a stud. She was so fine, she was so sexy. Like, I have no idea who this person is, but the being showed me their face, so I don't know what that means, but yeah, I feel like my mother is amazing, I love her, but I feel like, you know, certain connections is just, like, not there, or there needs to be, like, a barrier broken, I'm not sure, but I do, it's like, it kind of, you know, I remember when me and my, I called my older cousin and checked on her and made sure she's alright, because I was having dreams about her at one point, and I was just like, yo, you good? Because when you dream about a family member, it's kind of, like, suspicious, like, it's kind of suspect. Trippy, I don't know. So, yeah, like, we're, like, it's cordial, but, like, it's this distant, it is what it is, whatever. Nabata. But I remember when me and my older cousin were going through it and we're at odds, my mom was like to me, hey, what did you do to such and such? And I said, excuse me? I just thought it was, like, it was pretty hurtful for my mom to question me automatically and be like, hey, what happened with you and Thing? What did you say to Thing? It's like, how about you ask your child first if they're okay? You know what I mean? But not everybody thinks the way you as a person thinks, so I've had to, like, keep that in mind over time, and That's why I keep my distance and stuff, like, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do for yourself.
Whether others like it or not.
I'm like, you know, I get it. It's my older cousin, and you know, sometimes you think that you can, like, you know what? Not everybody is gonna have a tight-knit family and things flow how the storybooks say, but I wish it was a little simpler than how I feel. I've always been the black sheep of the family, I would say. But now I've came into myself and figured out my true passion, which is makeup, and y'all see me. I'm just a spiritual, sensual as fuck being and confident and living my life. I'm not worried about nobody else. And if a connection has to cut off, then so be it, period. That's all. You know, you don't have to carry hatred and feel in your heart, but you can definitely separate yourself for your well-being. You feel me? Yeah. You don't have to be around anyone you don't want to be around. You don't have to go anywhere you don't want to go. Or at least just take your time and bring yourself around folks when you're ready to. No one can force you to do anything you don't want to, you feel me? It's okay to take your time in life. Your life is your life. You don't live your life for people. I live my life for myself. Hopefully people can learn something or enjoy my YouTube, but I do it for myself because it makes me happy, period. It's not about other people. Never will be. Never was, never will be. I enjoy it. I hope you guys enjoy it. Comment down below. Okay, so I'm gonna put the darker the lighter blue on the inside and then the darker blue on the outside. And I like 'em in control. Okay, so now I'm just dabbing, I put some concealer in the middle, and then I'm dabbing a light, shimmery, gold beige, whatever. I can. So I put my lashes on, and I don't know if I did that in the last clip, whatever. And I did my foundation because like my video's running long, y'all. I need to like shorten this shit. But I'm gonna put on my concealer. Okay, so fucking creamy. I'm obsessed. Like that. Like that. Okay. And then you blend that shit, bitch. You blend that shit. Look how creamy that is. My god, like so fucking sexy. Okay. There. And you blend over the lip. Down if you want to. You don't have to do that, but whatever. And I feel like this wall's talking to me. You know, I love Kevin Gates. I feel like this wall's talking to me. In my own mind. Alright. Okay. Y'all see that creamy finish, right? Okay. And then in my other cover girl that I contour with.
No,
fuck. Anyways. Okay. If you know any better lashes, comment down below. Actually, I might as well put under my there too. Let me just blend the nose part on film. and then I'm gonna blend the rest off camera. Okay. It's all about the blending, bitch. Oh my god, I have such a potty mouth. I'm gonna blend this in, I'm gonna blend that and come back. I'll be back. Gotta warm that part up a bit again after the contour and setting powder mix it, you know. So warm that up, keep that no snatch, you feel me? Okay. I'll be back. So I'm just putting on some of my gold Becca highlighter. And yeah, I'll be back with the finished product. Okay. Okay.
No.